Hello, Wingate fans, and welcome once again to another edition of the Joe Reich Show. It's week three in the South Atlantic Conference, and the Bulldogs with the home and away all season this week on the road at Lenoir-Rhyne, a place that Wingate has had success and has won four against the Bears. But what a game it was, Coach Reich. Down 17 in the fourth quarter, one of the biggest comebacks in your career at Wingate. What a finish, what a game, just unbelievable. Didn't know what else to say, but unbelievable.
I wish I knew what to say on that, to be honest with you. It was just a great team effort. The guys just kept fighting and believing in one another, so it was great. It was great to see that kind of rally and come up with a big win against what we believe is a really good football team in LR.
You always take things back from a game, positives, negatives, try to work on them, try to build on them.
Sure.
Could you be any happier with the way the team came together? And as one, a lot of stops on defense,
right.
A lot of positive yards on offense. It had to be one to get a win.
Sure. Yeah, I think there were many positives from this game that were drawn out of it. And I think particularly because we just made plays when a play needed to be made. We made a play, whether it was defense, offense, special teams. I mean, obviously, we gave up a lot of yards rushing, and there were certainly some things we need to correct there. But I think when it came down to it, we made plays when we needed plays, guys that just stepped up and were big-time players in big-time situations, to say the least.
Well, let's check those first quarter highlights. 99 points. We'll show you quite a bit of them. Coach, LR obviously scores in the first two plays, the long run, so your offense gets the ball in the 40, and right away you check out Chris Bowden. We'll see this twice, and just trying to get some kind of positive yards after they score so quick.
Absolutely, just trying to get the ball to Chris, the little inside screen. You know, this kid is an up-and-coming player. We're just trying to find ways to get him the football. Felt like we could get the ball in his hands early, easy completion.
We'll see here on second down, a vintage Vince Jordan run, just pulling guys with him, always falling forward. It's just fun to watch him run the football.
He's got great feet. Again, just trying to hammer it up inside. LR, tough on defense, very physical inside.
Speaking of physical, Ryan Weber, one of those guys that, you know, has been a mold in your system. The tight end's always been successful. He takes a big hit here, but impressive. Ryan gets back up and gets ready for the next play. We'll see that one more time.
Sure. Ryan's been beaten up a little bit this year and physically, and doesn't have the numbers quite that he had last year, but you know, he just means so much to our team in terms of, you know, everything he brings to it, run blocking wise, pass game wise, just all around complete tight end.
One of two fourth down conversions here on the first drive, Coach. A little sneaker for Halfley. He did trip up a little bit, but just got enough, barely, for the first down.
Yeah, I thought he was going to get a little more out of that, but just slipped up a little bit.
Here's another nice run for Vince. Again, yards after hit, I know that's hard to keep up with in Division II, and you know, you don't see it as much in this level, but if you found out Vince or Nelson's yard after hit, I mean, it'd be so many.
That's something that Eric Mealy stresses, our running back coach, really stresses with those guys. Yards after contact, yak, we call it, you know, we got to get yak all the time. It's something that's a big emphasis for us.
Here's Ballin two straight times. There was a catch to get him down to the 15, and here's a touchdown, Coach. A filthy move. I don't know what you would call this, but he kind of stopped, spun around, and got
this has to be his own move, because we talked to him about several different options here, how to try to set this guy up. Chris kind of came up with his own little adjustment to that, and did a nice job. We felt like their safeties would be aggressive on the underneath stuff, throw it in behind, and we were fortunate enough to come up with a touchdown there.
So LR scores the next two possessions. And here's a miscue on special teams, Coach. A great bounce and unlucky play for the Bulldogs.
Sure, and that's just one of those things. We got to get on that, but it looked like, you know, ball bounced, hit an inch from the sideline and just dropped dead. It was a wet field, and the ball just literally just kind of stops.
It's a great nine iron, huh?
It really was. He stuck it. He stuck it right in the green, that's for sure.
So we'll go to the second quarter. Wingate down 21-7. LR will switch sides and try to go up by 21 points. And here's that toss play that worked well, but not here, as a great job, initial contact, and Mergerson and Stevens out there on the outside.
Sure, good job by Talon coming up. It's just, you know, we've got to be just a little more consistent here against this type of offense, for sure.
Here's the play one more time. Again, a big hit on the inside. Mergerson there, Stevens is there, and then LR will go to the air here, and Coach, get in the end zone. It was so tough to protect against the pass with Mergerson and Fletcher moving up.
Absolutely. We're trying to, you know, LR has got a nice little scheme, trying to suck you up on the run. If you look at the backfield at all, if instead of your man, you're going to get caught up here. And, you know, I think guys trying to go outside of themselves, trying to make a few plays there, because we were definitely struggling at that point.
So down by 21 points, and LR, after a Wingate three and out, gets all the way down the 40-yard line. It's just looking bleak, but here's the defense coming up huge. Bradley, a crushing hit, And if there's ever a bounce that goes one way, that was right in the hands of Fletcher, and he does what he knows how to do, and that's getting the end zone.
Absolutely, and that's you know, big hit. That was our hit of the week by Hamilton, popping the ball out. Just to, you know, this is probably to me, this is the play of the game right here. This is, you know, if they had scored in this point, it's tough enough to come back from what we had to come back from. That would have been, if they had scored at that point, it would have been very tough to come back from. So, great job by both those guys getting in the end zone and giving us a chance to stay in the game.
So here's LR again, scoring out 28-14, Coach, and needing another stop. The defense kind of fed off their energy, and we'll see a three and out here for LR. Watch first down, or excuse me, this is second down now, but just nonetheless, they kind of fed off their energy and got their first stop, forced punt in the first half.
And you're right on that. It was just a very clutch situation where we come up with a stop after a big play. That was going to be, you know, that certainly was a key for us in trying to stop these guys.
There's, a rushed pitch to the outside, causes the fumble. So here's third down for the defense. Again, Sanders trying to roll out and just kind of stuck up the middle. It was about third and 17. He did get 5 yards back, but the defense forces a punt, and here's the offense drive. We move it up to a third and 6, and a great catch by Weber.
Absolutely. Nice throw by Cody. Little quarter pounder here. Tried to draw him up. They're in cover two, trying to draw the corner up by running somebody into the flat. And Ryan makes a nice break here. Cody makes a nice read on the corner coming down and is able to throw the ball in behind and for a nice little game.
So that goes all the way up to the midfield, a gain of about 25. And then a nice gain here as Floyd draws the pass interference on a good play action. Defender on his back.
Absolutely. Nice little route. We worked on that during the week. Little out and up or out and in route that we work on that we felt like we could be successful with.
Here's a 4-yard pass. Ellington turns it into 25. Just so good are the wide receivers, Coach, of using their speed, agility, and making something out of a short play.
And with Delrick here, this is great. I mean, we really are he's caught so many balls for us there with a lower shoulder on a guy. Just continuing to be a physical player is what we're trying to stress with him.
So to the 11, Woods here, a short gain on first down. And then how about this bunch formation? Floyd kind of comes across. That's Cotton comes across, and Floyd just pops out behind.
Short down in the red zone, a lot of man-to-man typically. They actually weren't in man-to-man here, but we felt like we could run some interference to just get Perry underneath there. And obviously Perry did a nice job just catching and getting right up into the end zone.
So Wingate scores, but LR scores again, Coach, right before the half. You will get the ball to start the second half. Down 14 points at half. Not the worst thing that happened. You said the defensive touchdown was a huge play.
Sure.
You just never saw any quitting the guys, no matter what the score was.
No, and really, at halftime, the guys, it was as if it was 0-0. I mean, there was no panic. Guys were in there. And I think, you know, everybody's concerned, but I think everybody knows that you know, we can score some points on offense, we can score some points on defense. And I think at halftime guys were maybe a little shocked to a certain extent that we were down, but there wasn't a lot of panic. It was kind of like, all right, let's just go back out there and just execute one play at a time. And, you know, I'd like to tell you that we told them a lot of great things at halftime in this rip-roaring speech, but they just rallied themselves and did a nice job.
How difficult is it for an offense that likes to run 10, 12 plays, and then you play an offense like LR, it's looking for a quick strike to try to get the defense off the field? They can't be that tired because of the quick strikes, but you're dying to get that offense back on the field.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you want to – it was a mixed bag there. You know, they're scoring quickly, which obviously you don't want, but it's keeping the defense off the field. And we felt like conditioning-wise that we'd have a little bit of an advantage there because of that. I know that's terrible to say, but you definitely don't want that, but there were some advantages in that.
So we'll check out that third quarter. Wingate, a big mountain to climb.